Gary Neville's worst nightmare has indeed come true before our eyes. If you see him in Papua New Guinea, do let us know. Jamie Carragher, have you managed to speak to him yet?
No, I'm trying to get hold of him. It's just no signal. He's gone underground again, GNF, yeah. I mean, he said Man United were going to win the league before Liverpool at the start of the season. Top pundit.
Is there an important point here, Jamie, that the bragging rights are now on Merseyside as opposed to Manchester?
Yeah, certainly, you know, winning the title now, Liverpool will make a lot of it. You can imagine what social media is now. I'm all over it myself, letting Gary know. But listen, I mean, this Liverpool team now will want to emulate what Man City have done the last few years, where they retain the title, I'm sure, what Manchester United have done under Alex Ferguson, Gary being involved in those teams. You know, I don't think one title will be enough for this Jurgen Klopp and this Liverpool team. And you see, you know, the energy on the back of getting 97 points last season, winning the Champions League, you think how difficult it would be to go on and win the title this season. They've just absolutely ran away with it. But them and Man City, and maybe Manchester United as well, I think next season could really challenge for the title. But as I said, one won't be enough. And yes, it's great to get Liverpool back on their pitch.
What do you think, Jamie? Will there be hunger now for a team that's European champions, world club champions, and now Premier League champions, just to keep on dominating?
Certainly, that's the aim. You know, around the world, for the fans and everything, it will mean so much, because it's a global football club, Liverpool. All the guys will know that. Whenever you travel anywhere, there's thousands, millions of supporters, and this will mean so much to them, and it will get a new fan base as well. Of course you want to dominate, but it's not going to be easy. You know, Man City are going to come back stronger. They're going to want to buy players. Manchester United, Chelsea look like a good young team as well. But this team right now, they've got an opportunity of a lifetime to go and do it again. You know, those players, they're all going to be staying next year. If you maybe add one more up front as well, just to make the squad even stronger. Because it's probably a question that the guys, you know, Kenny, obviously Graham and Phil would know better than anybody. Because the amount of times they won titles, and then you think we rest on your laurels, and then somebody, a new player would come into the dressing room. That happened a lot, I'm sure, to all of you, didn't it, guys?
Absolutely. Ronnie Moran came into our dressing room mostly the start of the new season. And reminded us that you get nothing for last year when he was dishing out the medals for the year before. And so we got an early reminder. It was generally the second week of pre-season training when he'd walk into the dressing room with a box of medals, put them on the table and say, if you've played enough games and you think you've deserved one, you can have one of them. And then he'd walk out and he'd come back in 30 seconds later and say, oh, by the way, you get nothing this year for what's in that box. So we were always constantly reminded. But I think this is a group that, yeah, they'll need reminding occasionally, but the way they play, it's a power game for them. And I think what I like about their midfield, obviously that's an area I look at mostly, I think they take it personal. I think when they go out and they start a game, they are going to bully the guys they're in against. And I've not seen anyone get the better of them in that. Okay, people will play balls round them and they'll look cute against them, but eventually that power and determination and aggression gets to everybody. And that's why they seem so on the front foot in most games, or all the games, 99.9 of the games.